నమస్కారం. డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయ విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం.
Hello viewers, today's topic is balance of payments, and it is meant for second year MBA students. The course is business environment. So let us see what is BOP and who will prepare that, what are the items it contains, what is its significance. So balance of payments is a statement which records the transactions of the economy with the external world and which are captured in the form of accounting record, and it is a double entry accounting system, and the various sources are used in order to prepare balance of payment statement. And the Ministry of External Affairs and the Finance Ministry, as well as the authorized dealers of RBI and agencies located abroad by Government of India, will capture the information, and finally all the information is compiled by in the statement known as balance of payments. And in any country, generally central bank of that particular country prepares BOP. For India, the Reserve Bank of India is a central bank, so Reserve Bank of India prepares this balance of payment statements. It contains three major headings: the current account, the capital account, the reserves account. These are the main components of a BOP. So in the current account, we have three major divisions known as merchandise, non-monetary gold movement, and invisibles. Merchandise comprises two items, that is private and government. Private means any private organization which will involve in purchasing the materials or exporting the materials, importing the materials from various other countries. So in case of it exports, it will get the revenues from other countries in the form of dollars, or in the form of euros, or in the form of pounds, euros, all those kinds of things. Similarly, Government of India also imports certain merchandise, and similarly it may also export certain kind of merchandise. When it exports the materials, it will gain the foreign exchange for the country. When it purchases materials, it will have to pay, or when it imports the goods, it has to pay for those things. That will result in the outflow of the foreign exchange. Where non-monetary gold movement, that means it is not involved with any kind of gold movement. And third thing is invisibles. Invisibles indicates they are non-tangible items or intangible items where this is resulted. In the current account, we have both income as well as expenditure. Income means when we are exporting the goods or services to other countries, that will result in income. When we are exporting, we get the income. When we import, we have to pay for those things, that will result in the outflow of the currency. So in the intangibles, we have travel. Any persons traveling abroad may have to spend in foreign currency, which is provided by RBI. Similarly, transportation of goods, similarly insurance payments such as ships, all those aeroplanes, those kind of things, insurance may have to be paid. And investment income. Earlier, any investment was made in the other countries, the income generated from those countries, or if persons are, maybe government has invested in any other countries in the shares or securities, in those cases it may receive dividend or it may receive interest. It may be by government or it may be by private persons. Other than this, anything we'll call it as miscellaneous. Transfer of payments means any employees working abroad may be sending the money in dollars or in any foreign exchange, that will be taken into the invisibles. So 1 plus 2 plus 3, these three items comprise total current account. In case of exports or imports, those, if it is imports, that will be deducted from the total income, and so those things comprise current account. Then we will have capital account. Capital account indicates the any account, any investment made in terms of assets, where maybe purchase of machinery, maybe exports of machinery, maybe purchasing land or buildings, those kind of things will comprise in the capital account. That means any investment which will have recurring usage of that particular asset, that is known as capital account. In that we have three major items are there. First one is private, second one is banking related, third one is official one. In the private one, there are two other subheadings known as long term investments or long term borrowings, short term investments or short term borrowings. When we say long term, any period that is extending beyond 1 year is known as long term capital account, and anything below 1 year, that is short term capital account. For example, when FIIs invest in the stock market, that is foreign institutional investors invest in the stock market, they may withdraw within 1 year, which may be related to short term. And when it comes to long term, like FDIs, foreign direct investment, when they invest it for the long term, definitely it is going to extend beyond 1 year, because they are directly investing in productive assets. That is known as long term capital account. Banking, any banks involved in any foreign transactions, or maybe extending loans, or maybe borrowing from other banks, those kind of things will come in the capital account of banking section. Similarly, official things comprise three items known as loans, amortizations and miscellaneous. So, all these three things comprise total capital account, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3, that means anything that is outgoing is known as that will be deducted, and anything that is coming inside, that will be added to this. Finally, they will prepare a net capital account which comprises all these three items. And other than that, we have IMF, International Monetary Fund, which was found in 1949 with 29 countries. It provides money for the meeting the problem of balance of payments. The problem of balance of payments, generally what happens when your payments are exceeding the income, then there will be a shortage. In order to overcome that shortage, IMF facilitates the countries by providing SDRs. SDR indicates special drawing rights, where the member countries are eligible for those kind of things. So, in this case, what happens, SDR is only an artificial currency which can be exchanged for any other kind of items. When any country is facing balance of payments problem, that means there is a shortage for foreign currency, but still we have to pay. In those cases, the country will approach IMF, where IMF will provide this kind of service. That means every country member has to pay according to their share in the entire IMF, International Monetary Fund, where the money, whatever that a member country has to provide, should be in terms of some amount in terms of domestic currency, and something in the gold, and something in the foreign currency. But initially, every country has to pay in the gold terms, and whenever a country faces problem, it will approach IMF, where IMF will provide, and the loan is provided in 5 tranches. Each tranche means one installment. First installment is 25%. That means even if the member country has 100 million as a fund with the IMF, it can borrow up to 125 million. So, in that case, what happens? First tranche of payment or installment is granted without any kind of problem. They will simply grant once an application is made. But whereas second, third, fourth and fifth tranches, as each tranche a country is withdrawing, some terms and conditions are put, and IMF monitors whether this money, the money borrowed, is spent for productive purposes, or will it have any long term impact, positive impact on the country's economy. So, SDR allocation is also part of this IMF's grant. The item E contains B plus C plus D. This is a format of preparing BOP. F item contains A plus C items. Errors and omissions are those kind of items where if any mistakes takes place, they will be mentioned here in the item G. Finally, reserves and monetary gold are there. These reserves and monetary gold represent present country's reserves put together, all those things, current account and capital account also is taken into consideration. And if anything is falling short in the particular year, it will take out from the reserves, or in any year if there is a surplus, both taking current account and capital account into consideration, it will be added to the reserves and monetary gold. So, if reserves and monetary gold are positive, that means the country's balance of payments of position is good. And with regard to balance of payment system, we have a connection with the international monetary system. There are three major systems. One is gold exchange standard, which has existed from 1925 to 1944. That means up to Second World War end, it was continued, wherein the gold exchange standard also has two parts, that is gold standard as well as gold bullion standard. Gold standard was the earlier one where gold was exchanged for any kind of transactions, but the certain countries faced a problem because of non-availability of gold in that particular country. So, they could be excluded because of non-availability of gold. Because gold is not available in every country, such countries cannot involve in any kind of international trade. For that purpose, that gold standard was removed and gold bullion standard have come, where gold bullion standard mentions that it need not be always gold, there can be partially or fully paper currency can exist. But gold exchange standard was also discontinued after Second World War because many of the economies have been collapsed. So, again a new system had to come into existence, which is known as Bretton Woods system. This Bretton Woods system was existing from 1946 to 1971, where a meeting was held at Bretton Woods in order to facilitate the international trade. So, in order to facilitate international trade, they tried to identify a method where 1 ounce of gold was pegged to $35 and there cannot be more than 1% variation in the gold. It was relatively a stable system. Many of the countries did not face any kind of problem when Bretton Woods system was existing. But later on, because of the increase in the magnitude of the international trade, Bretton Woods system was found to be irrelevant, though it was not. Later on, they have introduced a floating exchange rate system, or we can call it as also present exchange rate system. This our current exchange rate system. This has started in 1971 and it is continuing till now, where the floating exchange rate system indicates that the exchange rate continues to vary or continues to change from time to time depending upon the demand and supply relationship of the country. So, when any country is involved in more exports than imports, it relatively its currency would be relatively very stronger when compared to other countries. Because availability of foreign exchange is there, so you need not purchase from the external markets or from other countries. In those cases, the country's rate exchange rate system is good. But when it comes to imports are more and exports are less, then what happens? There will be lot of demand for foreign exchange, where the local currency will become cheaper when compared to other currencies. So, in that case, the currency system will not be really stable. But when floating rates exchange rate system has come, people thought that it would bring in stabilization. But what the experience says is, at present, on an average, there is a variation in the exchange rate system at every 2 seconds. That means, foreign exchange rate is changing very drastically from time to time, creating volatility in the foreign exchange rates. So, what is SDR? So, we were discussing about IMF. IMF will allocate special drawing rights. So, these special drawing rights is created, it is an artificial currency created by IMF in order to overcome the problem of balance of payments. It would try to assist the countries which have lesser foreign exchange reserves than it requires. It has started in 1967, but it is based on a portfolio of widely used currencies. For example, dollar is part of that, Deutsche Mark is part of that, French franc is part of that, similarly Great Britain pound is part of that, Japanese yen is part of that. That means dominant countries which have majority share in the international trade, they have created this kind of currency, and based upon that its valuation will be varying. Then what about India? In 1991, the exports were only 4,200 crores. Of course, at that point of time, India was relatively secluded country in case of international trade, and there was a current account deficit of 600 crores. But however, later on, after liberalization, after 1991, when our Prime Minister P.V. Narasimhan was there, and erstwhile Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, who was a finance minister at that point of time, they thought that we cannot continue this way, because when entire market is becoming global, in that case they thought that liberalization should be brought in. So after that, liberalization, privatization, globalization have come into picture, and then this licensing raj was gradually abolished, and licenses became easier, single window systems have come, and then the government was encouraging private enterprises to come up, industries to come up, businesses to come up, banking system to go for better things. So this way liberalization has contributed that there was a lot of competition emerging, and then India also was traveling towards exporting more and more goods and services. For example, when we say services, software is a service, and BPOs are service, banking is a service, insurance is a service. All these things have added to 76,500 crores in 2013 and 14. The 76,500 crores is not just because of services, but it is also because of the trade which comprises tangible goods, exports of goods or machinery or textiles or different kinds of materials or items which have been exported to other countries, and so this has come up to 76,500 crores. But however, current account deficit, that means any transactions that took place under current account head, there was a deficit of 13,600 crores out of 76,500 crores. But when it was only 600 crores earlier, now it has grown up to 13,600 crores. The business has grown up to 18 times when compared to 1991 to 2013 and 14, but it has got the current account deficit has gone up to 21 times when we look at those kind of figures. There are the various factors that are affecting balance of payments is exports of goods and services. That means when you are exporting more goods and more services, it will add up to lot of foreign exchanges, and similarly inflation rate. If inflation rate is going up, naturally the value of the items will be going up, and it will be showing the foreign currencies are more coming into the balance of payment system. Similarly, world prices of a commodity are also will also affect this balance of payments. If the world price of commodities are going up, naturally the payment for those kind of goods or services will also go up. So this kind of increase in the prices of a commodity will add to the foreign exchange reserves of a country. And similarly, incomes of foreigners will also result in this kind of addition to the balance of payments. When foreigners' income is going up, generally they will go for foreign travel or foreign tours or medical tourism, and they try to purchase goods from other countries. The country from where the goods or services are received by foreigners, because of increase in the income of foreigners, that will result in the improvement of foreign exchange reserves. Similarly, trade barriers. If trade barriers are existing, then a country cannot do business with that particular country. In that case, what happens? There will not be any kind of imports or exports. Then that country will be secluded. There will be always a problem with the BOP. If trade barriers are not there, that will, sometimes it will affect positively, sometimes it will also affect negatively. If trade barriers are there, what happens? A country cannot sell its goods or services to that country, whereby it will lose an opportunity of earning foreign currency. Similarly, if trade barriers are there, a country may not be able to do business with that country, so that it will affect the balance of payments. Similarly, imports of goods and services will also result or affect the balance of payment statement, because imports of goods or services are always resulting in outflow of the foreign exchange, and this outflow of the foreign exchange will reduce the exchange reserves, which will be a problem in case if it exceeds. That means, if the imports exceed the exports, then it would be, there will be a resultant current account deficit or capital account deficit. So, we need to see finally whether current account deficit or capital account deficit finally results in positive outflow or positive inflow, that we have to look at. If it is a positive inflow, there is no problem with the BOP. But whereas in case of outflow is more than inflow, then there would be shortage, where the solution may be to approach IMF and temporarily to make adjustment. Otherwise, it is a question of credibility. If it results continuously deficit, then it is a problem. Few months back, our deficit was around $32 billion on account of current account, but now it has been reduced to $20 billion. That means there is a significant improvement, and the Reserve Bank governor also says it is a positive thing, and we are going to further improve this kind of thing. Similarly, value of domestic currency also affects the balance of payments portion. If domestic currency is weaker against any foreign currency, then we have to pay more for the foreign currency, and that means we have to pay more. Whereas, if the current if the domestic currency is stronger, then we need to pay less. This kind of situation has occurred in 2007, when many of the exporting companies have faced problem, because rupee was very strong against the dollar. When it was approximately 50 rupees, within 3 months it has come down to 39 rupees. So, this has resulted, the companies which were involved in exports, they were expecting more money, but they could not, because of the downfall of the dollar value or strengthening of rupee value, they have received lesser revenues, which was a problem on part of the exporting companies. But importing companies were happy, because they need to pay less for payments in dollars, because RBI could sell them the dollars at only 39 rupees, whereas these exporters have lost some money on that. However, of course, there are certain kinds of mechanism in order to protect the foreign currency. They may enter into futures contracts, or there may be hedging techniques which may be used when it comes to private enterprises or even government enterprises also. So, that way you can protect the foreign exchange. And similarly, domestic level of domestic income also results in the or affects the balance of payments position, because if there are higher levels of income, people would like to import the goods or services from other countries, maybe because of quality. They may have fancy for the items. In those cases, what they would do is they would try to spend money on traveling or tourism, procuring of foreign goods. These are maybe spending for sending their children for education to foreign countries. All these things will be affecting for this balance of payments portion.
మా కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియజేయండి. మా చిరునామా డైరెక్టర్ ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్ డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్ రోడ్ నంబర్ 46 జూబ్లీ హిల్స్ హైదరాబాద్ 500333.